Hello and welcome. My name is Daria Volkova and I can bring style to any visualization. In today's video, I will demonstrate how to create this dashboard, an elegant Grafana dashboard that displays web resources visits analytics. The dashboard that can be eyeballed in daylight by any C-level and the marketing team and provide sufficient input for the company's roadmap. Let's go! Any dashboard is a piece of more extensive IT system. In our case, the requirements we set for the system were delivery time in 3 days, 100% open source, 0% development, meaning we wanted to find ready-to-use parts and assemble them, one developer engineer to install and maintain the whole system, and ability to laser focus on C-level executive metrics. We planned to keep only measurements vital for business decisions. What has been requested? Where the request came from? And who made the request? For us, who is the country of each request origin? There is an article on our blog describing this system installation and configuration files. I will not go there today, but I would love to hear your thoughts about it if you like to share. In this video, I would like to focus on this part, Loki Data Source and Grafana Dashboard. Loki Data Source created a Grafana data frames, which are table-like structures based on the data stored in Loki. By our design, the data Promtail pushes into Loki has these 12 elements, 9 coming from Nginx and 3 are added by Promtail as constant, meaning these 3 have the same value for all records. To start, I go to Grafana, create new dashboard, and save it with a distinctive name. Add panel, add new panel, and select table as visualization. Then the data source Loki, the label browser is where to type your LogQL commands. I want all my elements, and I know that every single record has host equal to volkoflabs.io. Hooray, the data flow. Loki data source adds these 4 columns to my data, and the first column is my data. Now ensure that here is in the table section, the cell value inspect toggle is on. It will add this little eye icon on every cell in my table. I can click on any and here you go. Actually, not yet. I need to add JSON here. Here you go. It is my original data. The way how it's coming all the way from Nginx, optimized by Promtail and aggregated by Loki. One record is the same as one click or one user request. For a bit practice, let's say I only need what has been requested URI, and status, was the request successful or not. The results of this command goes here into the line column. I click this little I to view the entire value. This tells me that someone has requested about Grafana setup with success. 200 means success. I'm going to rename this panel to raw data and save. Now let's take a look at the final result on my dashboard. If I change the time range, the data changes accordingly. Beautiful! This panel contains the smallest granular of my data. I can start the aggregate and prettify process based on that. Here is the dashboard to go over today. All visual panels are Grafana natives, meaning the Grafana Labs team has developed and maintains them. These are connected directly to the Loki data source, and that one takes data from the GeoMap panel, meaning this panel reuses the previously requested data. Let's work on visuals now. Add a panel, add a new panel, select Stat from the visualizations dropdown, title Requests, data source Loki. I want the total number of requests. Every element has volkoflabs.io element limited by the Grafana interval. In the query options, it is essential to specify a minimal interval. logically, it should be no less than the smallest time range requested on the dashboard. Grafana's default smallest range is 5 minutes. That's what I will set up here. If I switch to the table view, I have counts of requests for every 5 minutes. This is what comes from the Loki data source. I want the total of all requests for the selected interval, not the count for every 5 minutes. I switch to the panel view. This is clearly not the total. In the panel configuration value option section, I change the calculations dropdown. I select total. Much better. Now I will work on the appearance. Change the color mode to background, and in the thresholds, I remove the default setting. Keep the base and select a nice purple color. Save, apply. My first is done. We got 22 requests during the last 15 minutes, and if I change the range to 30 minutes, then 54 requests. Next is visitors per hour. Add panel, add a new panel, select start from the dropdown for visualizations, then Loki data source, query options, minimum interval, 1 hour, since I want per hour. Type the LogQL query here. I request the total number of remote IPs counted across all existing labels. Again, since I know all my labels have the element host equal to volkaflops.io, let's do 2 days, for example. Switch to the table view. Now the Loki data source retrieves the total count of requests for every hour for the last 48 hours. I want to display an average. So here in the value options calculation, I specify average, and this gives me visits per hour on average. Switch to the panel view. Yeah, 32.6 sounds right for an average. Next, stat styles. The color mode background, and in the threshold, remove the default setting, specify the beautiful purple color. Don't forget to write a meaningful title. That's it for this panel. Let's take a look at the dashboard. Two meaningful stats look amazing. The time range is working. When I change it to 30 minutes, the numbers change accordingly. Here is what I got for the last hour. Next step is the GeoMap panel. Select GeoMap from the dropdown. Erase the title, data source Loki, query option, minimum interval 5 minutes. In the LogQL query, I ask for the total number of requests in every GeoIP country code. GeoIP country code is a 2-character value used for country name reference. If I switch to the table view, I see that every country goes into its own data frame. I can switch between data frames here. Let me select United States. I see the total number of visits from this particular country for every 5 minutes in the specified time range. If I switch to France here, I get the same view of another country. This is what the data source retrieves. I already know that my visualization panel, my GeoMap, expects data in a slightly different format. Therefore, before working on the panel configuration, I need to transform data layout. It could be done using data transformation. First is series to rows, which means taking those multiple data frames and combining them into one for visualization purposes. Here you go. Instantly, I have all countries merged into one data frame. And another transformation, I add group by time, keep as ignored, metric group by. The same concept as in SQL. I say to group by metric column, which is country in my case, and value calculate as total. Excellent. Now I have the total number of visits per country within a selected time range, all in one data frame. The metric is in the key value format. To convert it into value, down here there is an options section. In the legend, I say to replace key value of GeoIP country code with just value. Here, now for every country, I have 2-character values. After that, I can configure the visual panel itself, switch to the panel view to witness the results of my actions right away. In the map view, set the zoom to 2. In the map layers, I need to specify how to determine the location of the metric on the map. I want to use the built-in lookup by the country code, so the lookup field is metric. Gazetteer is the lookup dictionary. Grafana has 3. I select countries. I want the sizes of data points on the map to depend on the number of requests coming from that country. So style size is value sum. Same goes for color. I want it to depend on the value sum. Fill opacity equal to 1. The next section is base map layer. I like the ArcGIS map server with opacity 1. In the standard options, my color schema is from threshold by value. In the threshold section, delete the default and add 10 and 5 with my preferred colors. Save, apply, rearrange the panel on the dashboard. Next, I want to display the same data but on another visualization panel. Add panel, add new panel, select table from the drop-down, data source dashboard. That means exactly what I want. Take the data from the existing panel. Source the GeoMap. Use the same data transformation as on the other panel. And set the query option to minimum interval of 5 minutes. With that, I can start to work on the panel configuration. For this panel, I add a value mapping to have a full country name instead of 2-character country code. Click Add Value Mapping. Value US, display text United States. In addition, I want to see a country flag here to make my visualization more decorative. I will add it as a symbol. Then add another value, another, until I map all values. Unknown is mapped to the pirate flag. Instead of numbers, I want horizontal bars. For that, in the threshold section, I click Add Field Override. Select fields with the name, then select value sum, then add override property, cell display mode, and here choose gradient gauge. The visualization starts to come together, right? Then another add override property, standard options color schema, blue purple by value. I would also alter the column width, use another add override property, column width set to 200. Okay, now I like what I see. Save, apply, rearrange. Oh, one more thing. I'm sure you have the same thought. I need to sort. Open the panel in the edit mode, then click on the column header. Sorting appears. Apply and save the dashboard. After that saving, Grafana will remember sorting and visualization will sort the values. What do you think so far? How am I doing with my tutorial? I would love to hear from you in the comments or in our GitHub repo. Okay, get back to the dashboard. Moving along to the requested pages visualization, it is very similar to the requests by country. So I will right-click on the panel title and choose duplicate. In the edit mode, I change the data source and rewrite the logQL. I ask for the total requests per requested URI, and I only want to count the successful requests, meaning the status equal to 100. Specify the options down here to transform key value format into value format. Then add the same transformations I already added for GeoMap, series to rows and group by. Great, looking awesome. Save, apply, rearrange. Almost there, one more visualization left. The last visualization I'm going to cover today is counts by status. Dimes series visualization is selected by default, nothing to change here. The data source is Locky. Switch to the table view. In my LogQL, I ask for the counts by status. I count all records since I know that all records have host equal to volkovlabs.io. Counts should be calculated within Grafana's interval. Also down here in options, I specify to transform the key value format into a value format. For the query options, I want 5-minute intervals and not more than 24 data points, meaning not more than 24 bars on my chart. I switch to the bars on the right and go to the table view. If I have more, let's say 240, I need to extend the time range here. So the view is too matted. 24 is just right. Those status codes in the legend scream for English titles. I don't know if you can hear it, but I do. The mapping could be done in the transformation section in 2 steps. Step 1 is to combine all data frames in one. So I go to the transformation tab, then add join by field, keep mode as outer. I want all statuses regardless of how often they happen. And the field to join is time. Now in my table view, I have only one data frame and all statuses counts in separate columns. Step 2 is for second transformation. I need organized fields. Grafana prepares the list of existing field values. What is left for me is to specify aliases. Status code 200 is OK, meaning the request was successful. 206 is partial content. 301 is moved permanently, and so forth. Let's switch to the panel view and look, the legend now is in English. Now the last essential modification, colors. I will do it in the threshold panel configuration section. Add field override button, fields with name, and override property. Standard options, color schema, select single color. Now click on this gray circle and select the color. OK status I want in dark purple. Then repeat the same steps for 3 more statuses. I forgot to fill the bars with colors. It is done in graph styles. Gradient mode hue and fill opacity 100. Save, apply and rearrange to get the final look. I like how easy this dashboard illustrates what is happening with attendance, how well distributed the users worldwide are, and what are the countries the users are from. What are the pages that are most popular? Is there any malicious activities happening that require immediate attention? But just let me be completely honest with you. The world map displays requests with city precision. If the request comes from the US, you see this circle. From France, you see this circle in the middle of the country. It's not intuitive what the circle represents. You really need a second to realize that every circle means one country. I like how that is done in Google Analytics, where you have a country precision, which means the whole country is highlighted. GeoMap does not allow such configuration. In our real production dashboard, we use the Apache eChart panel to get the look with the most telling visual appearance. The whole country is highlighted. It's more intuitive than circle in the middle. Okay, let me sum up what I demonstrated today. In 3 days, we created a pipeline to collect, store, and visualize our website visits analytics. We used only open source software, captured only data elements that made sense to us, and created a dashboard that tells a story. Thank you all from all these great countries who visit our resources. We are happy that our work helps you to succeed in your projects. That's all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.